Right, let's generate a helmet. We're using the Z-sphere retopology method. And then we'll do the chin piece the same way. And a few other bits and pieces. So again, append a Z-sphere. Highlight the Z-sphere. X symmetry. Scale it down out of view. Down to topology. Edit topology. Okay, and onto the helmet. Right. I normally switch to using a mouse when I do this because the pen is just too sensitive, so. Okay, just draw out the basic line of the helmet. Try not to get too near the ear. We do want this to be generated from the surface of the head. The ZBrush is good. It instinctively tries to pull to the center line when you've got X symmetry on. It'd be very useful. Okay. Going an arc around the earpiece. Just join these together. Zoom in so we can see what we're doing. It's a nice little piece of geometry there. Follow that flow. We've got a couple of irregular vertices there that get shouted at. Again, we're just pre-vising. And again, this could be retopologized in Q-remesher. Okay. Across the top, just close this up. Ooh, a triangle and an irregular vertice. Ooh. Let me just follow this quite nicely across here now. Okay, we're nearly done. Close this up against the center line. We'll follow the same procedure we did for the chest piece in a moment when we create this geometry. Close this up, throw in a triangle. Ooh! Right, okay. Let's get it in position so we can see what we're doing. Adaptive skin down to 1. Preview, topology thickness. Just take it the other way. There. Maybe too thick. That's better. I like that. Make adaptive skin. Delete this. And append our new helmet. Make symmetry. And doesn't it divide well? That's beautiful. I like that. It doesn't actually look like it's growing into a head, so I'm just, while I'm here, grab the move brush. Just pull it away from the skin. Nudge the back out, and the neck. Pull the back of that out. Yeah. You can play with that forever until you're happy. Right. Okay, I think we're good to go. We'll just give it a gentle smooth. And reappend a Z-sphere. We'll do the chin strap while we're here. Scale the Z-sphere out of view. Down to topology again. Edit topology. Draw size nice and small. Start at the center. Draw motor helps. And across. Just bridge this now. To the end of the chin. Center one. Just do the second row. Should I bring that down there? We'll pull it out later. Okay. Two rows of geometry across the front of the chin. There. Let's have a preview. Density down to 1. We'll make the chin strap slightly thinner than the helmet. Okay, I'm happy with that. Make adaptive skin. Delete this C-sphere version and append our new version, X-symmetry. Now the chin is cutting through that slightly, so we will have to change that. Pull. Nice into place. Let's just tidy this up. And that's subdivided really nicely too. You just pull that into place. There, that's nice. A little bit of a smooth. I think that's quite flattering to her face as well. I mean, you can go in and add communication devices and all sorts of things. I think we'll just retopologize and produce a thigh piece in this method. So again, append a Z-sphere. X. Scale it out of view. Down to topology. Edit topology. We'll just quickly do this thigh piece. Okay. Right. Draw mode. And intentionally, I've taken X symmetry off because it can get a little bit confusing when you can see the piece on the opposite side. Take it round under a buttock. Across the front and up. Again, switching back to using the mouse. I think back to the first time I used ZBrush, I went a year and a half making all my models with a mouse, which is a strange discipline. When I discovered a Wacom tablet, it was just a revelation. I can see a point to the right there that's floating away from the model. We'll address that in a moment or two. Let's just get this first edge done. Oops. Sloppy. Undo. Control Z. A better position so we can see where we are. Alright, down to the corner. Across this bottom edge. Okay. Right. That's that leading edge loop created. Join this across. Right, let's just fill this in. Okay. I find retopology in ZBrush a mixture is. I'm just going to move that in. Can't remember how that pulled out. That's draw mode. I find it quite therapeutic. Now there are easier ways of doing this. You can take this into TopoGun or you can 3D coat. But I like the ZBrush environment. And this can be a very quick fix when you need to create something on the fly. I've been playing with Curie Mesher in ZBrush recently, and that's a game changer. That's an incredible tool. It does allow you to just sculpt freely without consequence, without regard for geometry, topology, and it puts it all right with a couple of clicks. Seems like all the old disciplines that used to be specialities are just going. I mean, they're becoming incidental. You no longer have to wonder how a car works, you just get in the car and drive now. And that's no disrespect to people who do things the traditional way. I'm in awe of box modelers. But I think I do live in the right side of my brain, so I like the fluidity of organic shapes. Okay, let's see how we can close this up. As many quads as we can, just for the sake of an exercise. We'll get this as good as we can. Is that closed? A for preview mode. And we change the thickness. A nice substantial, well, not that substantial. A little bit thicker. Okay, we'll accept that. Make adaptive skin. Delete the Z-sphere version and append our new one. What we do next to copy to the other side, there are two methods. We can clone it or press duplicate. Highlight the duplicate version down to deformation. Again, there's so many menus. Here we are. And hit mirror. And go back to the first one, we can merge it down. Yes. And X symmetry. Subdivisions. Really nice piece of body armor. And we'll do this with the new topology brush, I think, in the next video.